Hi, I'm Jim Covington. Today is January 24th, 2013. I'd like to welcome you to this week's issue of ISBA Statehouse Review. The General Assembly is convening next week, or the House is anyway, and I'd like to talk to you about some of the bills that have been introduced. And these are four bills. The first one, the bills have the same number, House Bill 110 and Senate Bill 110. Both create the Religious Freedom and Marriage Fairness Act. That require the state to recognize civil marriages between persons of the same sex. The Senate sponsor is Senator Heather Staines of Chicago, and the House sponsor is Representative Greg Harris of Chicago. If you recall, earlier this month at the end of veto session of the last General Assembly, there was a lot of activity on that issue. The second bill I'd like to talk to you about is House Bill 130, introduced by Representative Monique Davis of Chicago. And it requires, if a first-time offender is charged with a nonviolent offense, it requires the court to order the defendant released on his or her own recognizance, unless the court makes a specific finding that a cash bond is necessary to secure that defendant's appearance. It also allows, in addition to any other condition, as part of the order of release, that the defendant be monitored with a electronic surveillance device as authorized under the Unified Code of Corrections. That bill has just been introduced. The third bill is House Bill 128, also introduced by Representative Monique Davis of Chicago, that, to make a long story short, goes in and prohibits the state from using failure to pay child support as a method to jerk the defendant's driver's license. It also amends the Marriage and Dissolution of Marriage Act to prohibit the suspension of a driver's license for visitation abuse, which was recently enacted last year, in effect, I think, January 1 of this year, or delinquency of court-ordered support statement payments. And that has just been introduced. The fourth and final bill I'd like to talk to you about is House Bill 169, introduced by Representative John Bradley from Marion, and it cleans up the recently enacted Illinois Residential Real Property Transfer on Death Instrument, and it's the short acronym of that is TODI, Transfer on Death Instrument. It allows residential property to be conveyed, for lack of a better term, after the person who made it, death, without going through probate. And it's for people of modest means to be able to convey property in such a manner. And the title industry had some issues with that bill, which was a new way of doing business. And there's about five issues. In your written materials that are in part of this podcast, I go into more detail, but I'm going to just briefly hit the six issues. And this is an ISBA initiative to clean this up, because the TODI Act was our initiative. And the first one is the issue of more, if there's more than one beneficiary, it addresses that. The second issue is the, quote, authorized representative, close quote, is not defined in that. We do that. The third issue is the need for protection of bona fide purchasers. It goes in and does that. The fourth issue is the problems caused by the definition in the current act of residential real property for residential cooperatives and condominiums. And it goes through and kind of eliminates that, or for the condominiums, includes common elements as to what may be passed by a TODI. The fifth issue addresses the problems with agency under the powers of attorney. And House Bill 169 eliminates the power to create or revoke a TODI by an agent even expressly authorized under the agency. And the sixth and final issue has been caused by the problems caused by the strict adherence to TODI execution formalities. And House Bill 169 goes in and inserts the word substantial compliance, so that a mere technical error does not revoke or make it inadequate. And thank you for listening, and we will see you next week.